Peripheral blood smear preparation. Peripheral blood smear examination. A peripheral blood smear is a simple test that has great value in assessment of hematological disorders. First, we will look at list of equipments which are required. A clean glass slide, which should measure 75 by 25 mm and be approximately 1 mm thick. Slides should be grease and lint free. Ideally, should be frosted at one end to facilitate labeling. Spreader with smooth edge. Tissue paper. Applicator, as in a capillary tube. Personal protective equipment with gloves and container with 1% hypochlorite for discarding capillary tubes. Blood sample, that is blood collected in EDTA, which is preferred with identification, and lead pencil. After getting the equipments ready, verify the patient's identification on the sample. Wipe the glass slide with lint-free cloth to clean any crust immediately before making the smear. Mix the sample well by 10 gentle inversions. Take a small drop of blood with the capillary tube and place on the glass slide, 1 cm inside the opposite end to the frosted one. The capillary should be discarded into the disposal container. Now, without delay, place the spreader, which is thoroughly cleaned and dried if it was previously used for making a peripheral blood smear. Place this spreader in the front of a drop at an angle of about 30 to 45 degrees to the slide and move it back to make contact with the drop. The drop should spread out quickly along the line of contact. With a steady movement of the hand, spread the drop of blood along the slide. The spreader must not be lifted off until the last trace of blood has been spread out. The film should be allowed to dry in the air. In humid conditions, the films may be exposed to a current of warm air, like from a hairdryer, but this should be in a microbiological safety hood. A low wattage incandescent bulb may be used to dry the smear. However, care should be taken to ensure that it is not too close to the slide, or else it may result in drying artifact. The slide should be labeled with the patient identification number using the lead pencil on the head, that is thick end of the smear. After drying, the smear is fixed with methanol for 60 seconds prior to storage. If the slides are to be stained with Leishman stain in a short time, it need not be fixed immediately. The characteristics of an ideal peripheral blood smear are: the film should be about 3 cm in length. It should start about 1 cm from one end and end about 1 cm before the frosted end. The ideal thickness is such that on microscopy there is some overlap of red cells throughout much of the film's length. With anemic blood, one should use a wider angle, and conversely, with a polycythemic blood, the angle should be narrower. The leukocyte should be easily recognizable throughout most of the film. In a poorly made blood smear, leukocytes may be unevenly distributed, with monocytes and other larger leukocytes being pushed to the end and the slides of the spread. An irregular sticky film will occur if the slide is greasy. Dust on the surface will cause patchy spots. The film that is made with inconsistent pressure and irregularly edged spreader gives an appearance like this. If the fixative or the applicator contains water, water artifacts appear in the blood films. These are the storage-related artifacts on the peripheral blood smear. Anticoagulant-induced artifacts appear like this. Let us test our knowledge with few questions. Which is the recommended anticoagulant for the sample to be used for peripheral blood smear examination? Is it citrate, fluoride, or EDTA? Before taking a drop of blood from the sample for making a peripheral blood smear, which of the following steps is needed? shaking the sample vigorously, centrifuging the sample, or mixing the sample well by gentle inversions. What modification is required while making a smear if the patient's sample is known to be anemic? Increase the angle of spreader, decrease the angle of spreader, or no modifications required? What happens if an irregularly edged spreader is used for making a peripheral blood smear? Holes form in the peripheral blood smear. Smear is not possible to be made. Or serrations form at the tail end of the smear.